Good afternoon again, students. We are back with our next session. Pawan sir, are you able to hear me? Pawan sir, you're here. Pawan sir, if you can unmute yourself.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm very much here.
Okay, fine, sir. Fine. So we are about to start the session. Students,
are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. We are able to hear you. We are able to see you also.
Okay, good.
Very good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Very good afternoon.
So, just one small announcement before you start your session, sir. Students, we have been telling this many a times by now. You people need not write anything on the chat box except your question. So please refrain from writing anything in the chat box except the question that you have to ask. For the question, in the last 10 minutes, the speaker will be answering any 5 question. That is because of the time limit that we have. Pawan sir, the students will be writing questions and randomly you can select any 5 questions or as per what the time permits.
I would love to answer 50 questions if the time permits. No problem.
Yes, sir. But we have this time limit till 2 o'clock only. So we can start the session now.
Yeah, sure. Because we've already lost around 7-8 minutes.
Yes, sir.
Right. Thank you, Ranu. Thank you so much. So very good afternoon and Jai Hind to all the students. Welcome aboard IITTM family. So this is my first interaction with you. And I thought that since we all are facing this COVID-19 pandemic, so it becomes very pertinent to discuss about the impacts of COVID-19 on tourism and what is the way ahead. So today's session will be basically on the topic of tourism is the key for recovery of the industry. So I've chosen a topic like COVID-19 and tourism, the way ahead. So I will be dealing with that. Now, the agenda for today's discussion is the key discussion points will be, this is how the presentation will go ahead. COVID-19 pandemic scenario in the world and in India. Then the scenario of the jobs in the corona times. Then we will discuss about the predicted impact of pandemic on tourism industry as a whole. Then we'll come down to why tourism matters actually. The figures, why we lay so much of emphasis on tourism industry during this period as well. Then we'll discuss about the 2020 challenges for tourism. And lastly, we will discuss about the various strategies and the things that we need to do to restart tourism. I hope I'm very clearly audible to everyone. So you can just go through this content slide, the key discussion points. Now, where does the world stand? So today I was going through the WHO site. The entire world is under severe crisis due to the COVID-19 virus. And now India is at number 2 in terms of the number of COVID cases all across the world after the US. So more than half of the planet's population is under some form of restriction. Restrictions to travel, restrictions to gather, like majority of the places in India are still Article 144, Section 144 is imposed. That means you cannot have a gathering of more than 5 people at any place, barring the relaxations that are being given for marriage and other processions and all. So many tourism businesses have shut down all over the world, resulting in loss of livelihood. And we say in tourism parlance that travel and tourism was the first industry to be affected, and it will be the last industry to recover. So that is the huge impact of COVID-19 on tourism industry. If you guys remember March 24th, we had a complete ban on air travel within India. And March 22nd, we started a travel ban on international flights. So even before the lockdown was imposed in the entire country, the travel scenario was curtailed and it was a complete blanket ban on air travel in India, to and from India, and of course within India itself. So that shows the impact of the COVID scenario on travel and tourism. Now, as per the WHO, the confirmed cases across the world are 31.6 million. 31.6 million is more than the population of almost 190 countries in the world, right? So that is the huge impact of it. 190 देश हैं दुनिया के जिनकी पॉपुलेशन इससे कम है जितने की हमारे पास कोविड पेशेंट्स हैं ऑल अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड. नॉट एग्जैक्टली द पेशेंट बट द नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु हैव एक्चुअली बीन इन्फेक्टेड बाय 31.6 मिलियन. दैट मेक्स इट टू अराउंड 3 crore 16 lakh. अगर हम इंडियन सिस्टम के हिसाब से बोले तो 3 crore 16 lakh लोगों को कोविड 19 अभी तक हो चुका है. एंड ऑलमोस्ट अ मिलियन डेथ्स हैव अकर्ड इन द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. 9,72,300 people have died across the world because of this pandemic, which is huge. 10 lakh people have died because of the coronavirus. Now, coming to the scenario in India, this is the figure which I just took out from Arogya Setu app half an hour back. So COVID-19 cases just around half an hour back in India were 57,32,518. So roughly around 6 million people within the country are affected because of this particular virus. And we've had 91,149 deaths so far. Now, if the current rate goes on, I'm not sure what will be the scenario by the end of this particular year. We may have crores of people affected within India itself, leave apart the entire world. We might become the number one country in terms of the people who are affected due to coronavirus. But the good news is that the recovery rate in India is the highest in the entire world. We have around 81% recovery rate, which is the best in any of the countries in the world. So we are suffering a lot, but then a lot of people, almost 81% people are recovering well out of this pandemic. Now coming to the second part of it, the jobs in times of corona. So I've tried to give you some figures related to the various aspects of tourism and other industries. So if we begin with hospitality and tourism, the industry size of hotels is around 37,000 to 39,000 crores. Tourism roughly has 18 lakh crores income within the country itself. And total employees working in travel and tourism sector are around 40 million. Yani ki 4 crore log directly, indirectly tourism travel se में employed हैं country में. But the impact of corona will be that the tourism body expects around 1.2 million direct job losses. And in tourism, we have a concept of multiplier effect, wherein we say that one direct job creates almost 5 indirect jobs. So if we have 1.2 million, यानी कि करीब 12 lakh direct job losses होंगे, so करीब करीब 60 lakh indirect job losses भी हो सकते हैं tourism की वजह से या corona की वजह से tourism industry में. Ancillary industries like logistics, which go hand in hand with tourism, will take a severe hit. There is an organization called Hotel Wait, which estimates that there will be a revenue loss of around 9,600 to 11,400 crores in the short term, and there will be a drop of 27% to 32% over the last year. But the figures of the first 6 months from January to June, world over, says there has been a drop of 65% in the travel and tourism industry alone. 65% drop is a huge figure. Then 15% to 25% casual or contract employees, which are basically seasonal in nature, because tourism industry is greatly affected by the seasonality aspect. We have various seasons. So there are 15% to 25% workers which work only for a particular tourist season on contract or on casual employment. So they will be the first one to have the biggest blow. And Indians make up to 10% of the global cruise line staff. पूरे वर्ल्ड में क्रूज लाइन में काम करने वाला एवरी 10th पर्सन इज एन इंडियन. दैट मींस 10% ऑफ द वर्कफोर्स बिलोंग्स टू इंडिया एंड मोस्ट विल लूज देयर जॉब्स. दे हैव ऑलरेडी लॉस्ट देयर जॉब्स. नाउ कमिंग टू द रेस्टोरेंट्स, इंडस्ट्री साइज अराउंड 4.2 लाख करोड़ एंड टोटल एम्प्लॉइज अराउंड 7.3 मिलियन. द कोरोना इंपैक्ट इज 15% to 20% जॉब लॉसेस लाइकली एज ऑफ नाउ, बट द फिगर विल बी हायर बिकॉज दीज आर द फिगर्स टिल जून. And though we are into a reopening phase, unlock phase 4 mein hai hum, so restaurants ko khulne ki permission de di gayi hai, but the footfall is extremely low because of the fear of the coronavirus. So we may see at least 40% to 50% job losses from coronavirus impact on the restaurants. and of course impact would be bigger, and the figures now coming in say that the impact is bigger. Now coming to retail size, retail industry size is 59 lakh crores and total employees are 46 million. Retail had a very severe loss because of the lockdown scenario, but after the unlocking system has been put in place, we are slowly and steadily going to normalcy in retail, barring the big malls wherein the footfall is extremely low. And of course, one sunshine side of this has been that the retail, online retail has gained momentum because people now are preferring to buy online things rather than visiting a particular shop. So in brick and mortar retail scenario, we expect that there'll be a 25% job loss. Now coming to aviation, which is the hardest hit industry of all, industry size is 2.2 lakh crore and total employees are 3,50,000 approximately. So there is an organization called CAPA, which is Center for Asia Pacific Aviation, which estimates around 4,200 crores in the April-June for private carriers. And since that was the period of complete lockdown, I believe the actual figures will be much, much higher than that. Even in a locked system, the flight numbers are very restricted and people are not preferring to travel by air. Though India has entered into an agreement, which is known as the air bubble agreement with various countries, like Dubai and UAE and Malaysia and all, but the number of passengers going there and coming from there is extremely less as compared to the pre-COVID scenario. Now, if the crisis continues, then 150 aircraft will be completely grounded. In India, we have roughly 650 aircrafts as of now in the domestic scenario. So out of that, if 150 are completely grounded, that means almost 1/4 of the aircrafts will have no use as of now. So that becomes a cost on the aviation sector, because the aircraft is, utility of an aircraft is when it flies. That is the time when it earns money. If it is grounded, it is a cost to the organization, it is a cost to the entire country, because you have to pay parking charges, you have to pay hangar charges, there is no revenue coming out of it, you have to pay your employees. This is a huge, huge loss, to say the least. Then a lot of organizations like GoAir had asked their employees to go on rotational leave without pay. Indigo has retrenched its employees by almost 500-600. So overall, the job scenario becomes very, very pathetic. There have been salary cuts of almost 1/3 to almost 50% of the salary has been cut down because of the pandemic scenario. Then coming to another industry, which is real estate, which is closely related with tourism. Industry size is 13.32 lakh crore and it is the second largest employer after agriculture industry. The corona impact has been that there have been already 20% jobs have been wiped out in the real estate scenario. But with the unlock, we expect that it will pick up very soon. The outbreak will have almost 35% job losses. But I am a bit optimistic now, considering the unlock and the push that the government is giving to the real estate because of the employment potential of this industry. I'm pretty sure that very soon we might reach the pre-COVID scene in terms of real estate. But during the pandemic scenario, before the unlock, we had almost 35% job losses. You must be aware of the precarious scenario where we had migrant laborers going back to their villages. Majority of them were working in the real estate as such. Then ride hailing services, industry size is 11.84 crore, total employees of 5 million, right? Ride partners largely in Ola and Uber. And the corona impact was, there was a, even after the lockdown, there was down. Drivers' earnings have been hit because people are restraining from traveling through ride hailing apps, and so they are losing a bit on their incomes as well. Then online food delivery, you must have heard people from Swiggy. Swiggy partners have gone to the court. They have been on strike for a few days because their incomes have been affected. Industry size is 48,000 crores and total employees around 5 lakh, which are basically flexible jobs, right? This is as per the internal estimates of Swiggy and Zomato. So initially they expected no immediate job loss, because just after the first lockdown, online food delivery services were allowed to operate, but then their income still dipped 20% because of the coronavirus impact. Cinema and entertainment is completely locked down. Still, there is no permission being given for the cinema and entertainment hubs to open up. They had around 1.82 lakh crore industry size and total employees were 7 to 8 million. So job cuts were not discussed as such, but there are job cuts in the entertainment industry, there are job cuts in cinema, and there is a pressure to mount if crisis continues. They had opened up shootings and all, but then another pandemic breakdown is that every day you listen some of the other actor or the film crew being affected by the coronavirus, so that again takes a big toll. E-commerce, 22.7 lakh crore, total employees are 6.1 million as per the Indian Staffing Federation. This is only sunshine sector. The online shopping has gone up, so there is no immediate downturn effect, but there is a positive impact of this pandemic on the e-commerce. But going forward, if the crisis persists, the demand will sink and there might be a 20 to 30% job losses. For one reason, when there'll be job losses, so people will have less disposable income in hand. And when we have less disposable income in hand, we will be spending less on our purchases. So by this indirect method, e-commerce industry will also have an impact in near future if this pandemic is not controlled or the vaccines don't come very soon. Then temporary staffing, of course, with one of the biggest hit industry, they have around 44,000 crores, total employees of 4.1 million as per Indian Staffing Federation 2019. So face-to-face interviews are out, online system is in, then tech demand is freezing up. Those who can't work from home to be hit the most, because you have to have good internet connection. Like we are teaching you online, though we would have loved to meet and greet with you personally, but since the pandemic is there, so we have to go through the online system. The next two quarters as well. Now coming to the topic of COVID-19 and its projected impact on tourism. So the biggest victim of COVID-19 pandemic has been the travel and tourism industry. I mean, there is no second thoughts on that. 100 to 120 million jobs are at risk, and it is estimated that $910 billion to $1.2 trillion will be lost in exports in the travel and tourism industry because of COVID scenario. And this 1.2 trillion, chota sa figure lagta, but trillion itself is a big figure. If you see $910 billion, so I would give you that roughly $1 billion is 7,500 crores right now. So you multiply 910 by 7,500 crores. So your paper, if you write it, then your line will be finished, but it will not be zero. It will be itne zyada crore ye rupayon mein aayega figure. Then international tourists, there will be loss of around 850 million to 1.1 billion international tourists will be less. That means almost 50% of the tourists will be wiped out internationally. So in India, tourism sector may face overall loss of around 5 lakh crore and job cuts for 4 to 5 crore people, direct and indirect and induced employment all taken together, which is huge. Now, IMF, that is International Monetary Foundation, says that there will be a 2 percentage point loss in annual GDP for each month of the lockdown. So we've had almost 2 months of lockdown. So a rough estimate says that 4% there'll be a decline in the GDP. But the new researchers which are coming up are saying that India might have a downgrade in GDP almost 25 to 30%. First 6 months already have had shown this figure, 25 to 30% less GDP as compared to 2019. So the pandemic has ravaged all major tourism corridors in the world, affecting both tourist generating as well as receiving regions. Now, generating region is the area from where the tourists belong. Receiving region is known as the place where the tourists go, the destination. So if I go to Singapore, then India is the tourist generating country and Singapore is the tourist receiving country or the receiving region. So this pandemic has affected both because air travel international is still at its nascent stages of recovery. And we are entering into air bubble agreements with various countries. In these two countries, ke beech mein aircrafts fly karenge. So as per the various tourism bodies in India, overall job losses for the entire tourism value chain, which includes your hotels, restaurants, airlines, tour operators, transport providers, and all other like business may lie between 38 million to 50 million, which is great and huge. Now, COVID costs show you that tourism, aviation, and hospitality are the worst hit. So independent economists expect that 1 percentage point in financial year 21, which is, I believe, which is going to be high. So lot of industries have got lot of monetary stimuli from the government. So hospitality and tourism industry has also been demanding to give a physical monetary stimuli to the industry, right? So this is what we have been doing. So IATA, there is an organization called International Air Travel Association, which schedules your aircrafts everywhere. So IATA ही वो organization है जिसकी वजह से आपके flights scheduled होते हैं, उनके permission से ही चलता है. So COVID-19 will wipe out around $190 billion from all this figure. So tough times ahead. There were all tourist visa was suspended till April 15, and then of course unlocking May we've started giving a few fresh visas now. Tour operators say the ban will have a cascading economic impact. It will lead to job losses in hotel, aviation, and travel sector. So they have asked government to review the situation after every 10 days, and they are seeking waiving of the GST dues for the period of ongoing forward reducing the rates. So a lot of industry stalwarts which belong to various of the GST, right? So if we come to travel and tourism, airlines will lose around 8.4 lakh crore in global passenger revenues. Alone Kerala, hotel occupancy were down to 30 to 40%, and there were 100% cancellations from Japan, Malaysia, China. And to brief you that we had 2,80,000 Chinese tourists visiting India in 2018. This will almost be down to almost 1% or 2%. Almost, I can say it will be 0%, considering the heightened tensions between India, China, and of course the pandemic scenario. We will be losing all these tourists coming to India as well. Now, coming to the third part of the presentation, why tourism matters? Why do we say that tourism matters? क्या फिगर्स हैं, क्यों हम कहते हैं कि टूरिज्म कितनी इंपॉर्टेंस है? Now if we say tourism matters, then 10.3% of the travel and tourism GDP is the percentage of global GDP. That means if we earn 100 rupees, then 10.3 rupees are contributed to the GDP alone by travel and tourism. So $1.7 trillion visitor exports were there in 2019. And I've just told you 1.7 trillion makes it to 1,700 billion, and 1 billion is equivalent to 7,500 crore rupees. So you can very well imagine the huge impact it has. 330 million jobs are supported by tourism and travel in 2019, and one out of every 10 persons job creation in the last 5 years has been in travel and tourism. So in the last 5 years, every 10th job created world across has been in the tourism and travel sector. We talk a lot about automobile and software and everything, but one of the biggest employment generating sector or industry in the past 5 years has been tourism and travel alone, wherein every 10th job created belongs to tourism. So these are some of the figures for India. In 2018, we had 10.56 million foreign tourist arrivals. These are known as FTAs, foreign tourist arrivals. We had 10.56 million. So roughly 1 crore and 5,60,000 people visited India from abroad. As far as domestic tourism concerns, we had 1,855 million domestic tourists in India. Now to brief you that you might have a question in your mind, our population is 1,300 million, that is 130 crores. How can we have 1,850 million tourists? As against 1,300 million population, we are showing domestic tourists at 1,855 million. So just to brief you, it is the number of visits, not the actual number of passengers, right? So if I travel 20 times, I'm counted as 20. So what this 1,855 million is the actual number of visits done by Indians within India. Now coming to the FEE part, that is the foreign exchange earnings. So these 10.56 million tourists have spent 28.6 billion foreign exchange earnings in India in 2018. Now if we translate this 28.6 billion into Indian rupees, it will be roughly around 1,95,000 crores. So this 1 crore 560,000 tourists coming to India have spent 1,90,000 crores in India, which is huge, right? And in India, the contribution of GDP of India is 5.6%. So agar hum 100 rupees banate hain desh ki GDP mein, to 5 rupees 60 paisa alone is contributed by tourism industry, which is a huge considering the number of industries that we have. This contribution is extremely high. Now coming to the another part, what will be the challenges for tourism in 2020? So tourism is built around mobility. We need to be mobile. We need to move around from one place to another. And the biggest casualty of this pandemic has been curtailing in the travel. So tourism is built around mobility, and the enabling mechanism of consumption that are mostly intangible are greatly affected. The closing down of entire cities and countries, travel restrictions, bans have brought the tourism and transport sector to a standstill. I just told you 1/4 of our flights are still grounded. Aircrafts are not in use. From the biggest airline to the smallest hotel in a rural community, the sector has been halted. It's a complete blanket ban right now. Then according to Center for Asia Pacific Aviation, the domestic traffic could fall by almost half, from around 140 million in financial year 2020 to around 80-90 million financial year 2021. This is what we expect. The impact of this crisis of this magnitude will crush the industry if very soon we do not get some signs of recovery from COVID-19, or we do not get the vaccination done. Then coming to international traffic, it is also feared to drop approximately 70 million to 35, 40 million alone. As a consequence, around 250 aircraft would remain surplus in the next 6 to 12 months in India alone. And 50 were already down, and we expect if the scenario continues, we may have almost 200, 250 aircrafts out of 650 available currently, they'll be grounded. Tourism shutdown has resulted in low levels of occupancy in hotels and severe loss of revenues in both organized and unorganized sectors. Slowly and steadily, we are opening up the hotels and the homestays, but because of the curtails in travel, you very rarely find people traveling from one place to another for tourism purposes. But there are states in India which have recently opened up for tourism, like Himachal Pradesh, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand, with certain restrictions, because there is also a thing called isolation or quarantine. So some of the states still have that policy of 7 days or 14 days quarantine period, which is still a dampener, I would say. Like, I was a very vivid traveler, and I have not traveled. I've just traveled twice out of Delhi NCR in the last 6 months, twice or thrice. That too for official work and once for personal work. But if you think of tourism perspective, I have not traveled in the last 6 months out of my city for tourism perspective. And if I wish to go to Goa, even during this pandemic, I'll have to have a quarantine of 7 days in Goa. So this again becomes a dampener. So there are states who have waived off this quarantine period. And recently I was watching an advertisement of Uttarakhand Tourism. Initially, they came up with a scheme that you have to come to Uttarakhand at least for 7 days and you have to have a hotel booking or a homestay booking for 7 days. Now they have curtailed that down to 3 days. So anybody who wishes to go to Uttarakhand can go to Uttarakhand by having a 3 days, 3 nights and 4 days booking, and they can go there. So these are small steps which are being taken by various states in the country, but international level, still you don't have such type of things happening. The women, the indigenous communities, the lowest scale socioeconomically weakest groups that usually flock around the massive informal sector are the ones who are bound to suffer the most. And tourism and its related sectors have completely shut down and have no certainty in future. Like I just said, our industry will be the last to recover even if the vaccination system comes into force very quickly. Right, so current scenario, borders of at least 90 countries remain closed completely or partially. Another 44 countries have blocked the entry of visitors of certain nationalities. Travel restrictions in 209 destinations across the world have grounded the tourism industry that was in the midst of a dream run. Our growth rates were very, very good. And in fact, growth rate in India was much higher than the global averages. Global average was around 4% and India's growth rate was roughly around 6% in 2018, which was expected to be better in 2020 before the pandemic struck us. Only a few countries in Europe and Americas do not have travel restrictions that came in different forms. That is overall or partial border closing, complete and partial suspension of flights, destination wide travel restriction, other measures. So very few countries in Europe and Americas do not have a travel restriction. Rest of the entire world is almost closed down right now. So the cost of these restrictions is huge, especially for low income countries like India. One of the biggest sources of income was tourism. And I've just told you the direct impact contribution of tourism in GDP is 5.6%. That entire money has been wiped out from our GDP. Now coming to the last part, which is the longer part, how do we restart tourism? Now this is what the bad things we have seen because of pandemic, but we cannot just lie as a dead body. We have to come up, we have to rise up to the occasion, we have to find out the ways and live to the new normal. So living in the pandemic scenario will be a new normal now. This disease is not going to go out so very soon. So we have to learn to live with this disease and still grow. So we have to think of restarting tourism and how do we do it. Now, 6 ways how COVID-19 pandemic will change tourism. For that, you'll have anxiety management. You'll have seamless travel impact. Now, anxiety, the management of anxiety and fear of COVID-19, as well as a trust deficit in things perceived by the public. Like I just told you, in the last 6 months, I've not been able to travel. And maybe one of the reasons for that is anxiety. I wish to travel, I'm craving to travel for recreation purpose, but I've not been able to do it. Family pressures, peer pressures, people everywhere, everybody is saying, no, don't go. These are corona times, you should not venture out of your house, don't do this, don't do that, don't go here, don't go there. Right, so going from one city to another city for tourism perspective, definitely it has been changed. So there's a lot of anxiety of travel, anxiety towards travel, fear of travel, among the potential travelers and the people. Then there is an impact on seamless travel. I just told you that tourism basically is an offshoot of mobility. There has to be seamless travel. So seamless travel is crucial and it calls for greater cooperation, coordination at various level, which has been greatly impacted by this pandemic. To be backed by focused communication and campaigns to emphasize confidence building. Like I just quoted an example of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Himachal and Uttarakhand. They have started the campaigning to build up the trust of people that we are lesser impacted by COVID. We are taking all protocol measures. So you are welcome as a tourist to come to our state. So going forward, another 1 year or so, I see there will be a increase in the domestic tourism, or rather the entire industry will survive on domestic tourism and international travel will take a back seat. Then the third change is on domestic tourism. So pandemic actually brings an opportunity in India's surging outbound tourism segments. The possibilities are there. Certain segments of the market may skip outbound travel due to the risk involved. So if I'm craving to go, but there are travel restrictions, so I may wish to travel within India. So in the hindsight, at the back of my mind, whenever these restrictions are gone, I would say that being local, being vocal for local will be the catchword in tourism industry also. Aane wale samay pe hoga ye slogan ki aas paas dekho. So long distance travel will be avoided by people. So this might turn out to be an opportunity for greater domestic travel within the country, which jaise jaise abhi samay guzrega, hume maloom chalega, we'll have more unlockdown measures coming into place. I personally feel this can be a big opportunity for domestic travel to grow. With right prices and product mix, such groups can be motivated to explore more domestic destinations. So people who wish to travel abroad may now like to travel within the country. So this can be one segment who were basically outbound goers can now travel within the country itself. Then the impact on small businesses, with the tourists searching for safer stays and personal care, smaller accommodation units like homestays may be in greater demand. So we might see people shifting from big five-star hotels to smaller resorts or home vacations, right? So in tourism, I've witnessed in the last 3 or 4 months, people have started publicizing, come and stay with us and work from our resort. So the vacation homes are actually gaining a lot of importance in the last 3 or 4 months. Now coming to the priorities for tourism recovery, we'll have to provide liquidity and protect jobs, recover confidence through safety and security, then private public collaboration for an efficient reopening is required. These are some of the strategies for the tourism recovery. Open borders, but open borders with responsibility. A free flow movement is not possible as of now. Then harmonize and coordinate protocols and procedures. Like I told you, if I have to go to Goa, there is a protocol of 7 days quarantine. Now if I go to Uttarakhand, there is no such quarantine period. So we need to harmonize and coordinate on the protocol and procedures. But since it's a state matter, every state is free to decide on the procedures as far as isolation and quarantine is concerned. Then add value to jobs through new technologies. Like since the unlock has started, some of our students have started virtual tours, and I'm glad to share you that these are all paid assignments. One of our students who is working with an international brand as a tour manager, she has recently started the virtual tours. So the tourist is actually not here, but she's traveling with a camera, which and a live feed is being given to the tourist. So Chandni Chowk mein walk ho rahi hai, where the tourists are actually not walking with the tour manager, but the tour manager is walking with the camera and the live feed goes to the tourists sitting in America or Britain or somewhere, any part of the world. So these are some of the things which we can mobilize. So adding value to the jobs through new technologies. Then innovation and sustainability will be the new normal. Now I'll just share a brief on a survey done by Condé Nast, which is one of the most prominent travel magazine. So they did an Indian luxury travel report, COVID edition, which was done by Condé Nast Traveler in May 2020. I'm just sharing some of the highlights of that. Now, the first thing was 81% of the people said yes on being asked whether you miss traveling more than anything else, which is a very substantial number. So out of 100, 81 people said more than anything else, they miss traveling. That means people are craving to travel, and we academicians have coined a word which is known as revenge tourism. So we feel as the things will get normal, people will travel as a revenge against COVID-19, and we'll see much more travel as compared to the prior scenario. Then another survey, as part of the survey, another question was, are you open to an international vacation this year? 21% said definitely open, and 49% said depending on the situation. So almost 70% people are ready to travel. Out of them, 21% are definitely open. Whatever the scenario, they will love to travel if the international travel allows. And 49%, that is roughly 50%, are ready to travel, but their travel decision depends on the situation. Then domestic tourism will have a huge increase in affluent travelers. A lot of affluent travelers who used to travel abroad will not travel abroad because of the scenario. So this is, again, I'm reiterating, one good sign for the development of domestic tourism in India. 43% of the respondents are already considering a vacation in India, and 43% again will see how the situation unfolds. So that means almost 50% of the respondents from India are already raring to go to travel within the country, which is a positive sign. 53% are ready to drive or to fly. So like I said, Aaspaas Dekho may be the catchword in the coming times. So people will love to drive to the nearby vacation points. So 53% are ready to drive or fly. 32% will prefer to drive, and 15% will prefer only to fly. So again, where luxury travelers want to go in 2020? This was a question asked to the respondents from India. 37% said they would like to go to Maldives. This is an answer for the luxury travelers, right? 31% said they want to go to Central Europe. 30% said they want to go to Southern Europe. 30% again said they want to go to Australia and New Zealand was their first choice. And 28% to Bhutan, 27% to Sri Lanka. Now, if you see Bhutan, Sri Lanka, nearby countries, so people will prefer short haul duration flights rather than going to long haul. So, agar aap dhyan se dekhen, inme se kahin ki bhi flight 8 ghante se zyada direct flight nahi hoti, barring Australia and New Zealand. And Southern Europe includes Italy, Greece, Spain, and Portugal. Central Europe includes Switzerland, Croatia, and Germany. Now, coming to the domestic part of it, what are the top 10 destinations for luxury travelers? The choice, the first choice of luxury travelers within India, 50% chose to go to Goa. 48% said whatever is COVID free at the time. That means almost 50% of the people are ready to go to anywhere in India where it is COVID free. 44% vouched for Himachal Pradesh. 31% vouched for Leh and Ladakh. 31% wish to go to Sikkim, 28% wish to have a luxury travel to Kerala, 28% to Uttarakhand, 25% had their first choice as Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and 23% had their first choice as Rajasthan. Then another part was, where would you like to stay? 38% said a hotel, which is part of a trusted chain. 20% said a boutique hotel with fewer rooms. 17% said a homestay, and 25% preferred a private villa or an apartment. So you can very well see almost 1/4 of the people who responded want to stay in a private villa or apartment. So what I just said, there'll be a paradigm shift in the choices of accommodation of the tourists post COVID. So what luxury travelers are willing to pay more for safety and destination? 53% are willing to pay extra for daily deep cleaning. 37% would pay extra for one night buffer where the room remains unoccupied for a day before arrival. Now these are the measures which people are ready to pay extra for creating a scenario which is COVID free, right? Or at least the anxiety levels are less. 37% are ready to pay one night extra if that room is not given to anybody else one day prior to their arrival. The 9% would pay extra for a personal butler or attendant or a resort host. 37% are not willing to pay extra for any services. Then importance is given to follow proper sanitization and hygiene protocol. Everybody is talking that proper sanitization hygiene protocols have to be there. That is one of the first and most important requirement in today's world. Now, is there any part of travel you feel uncomfortable about? So 10% said no, 22% said use currency to pay, 23% said using a fleet lab they are uncomfortable about, 32% said eating out of reusable plates, they are uncomfortable, 38% said using aircraft or airport lavatories, they are not comfortable with, 55% said they are uncomfortable having to touch surfaces that others are touching. 64% said being part of a crowd or standing in line with others is what makes them uncomfortable. 75% said not being certain that everyone is following proper cleaning protocol. So there is an anxiety. 75% people are not sure whether others are following proper cleaning protocols or not. Then what should be done regarding air travel? Implementing appropriate health check procedures. Consider providing masks, sanitary tissues, PPE kit to passengers and crew. Low contact and technology-based boarding and deep cleaning process. Reducing movement and number of objects within the cabin. People not sitting next to each other where load factors make it possible. These are some of the issues that travel needs to cater to. This is a picture of how air travel has reopened. These are the flight crew who are all in PPE kits, right? And you see the passengers having face masks and face covers. And you can see the air hostess also wearing face mask and entire PPE, whole body PPE kits.
Pawan sir, if I can please excuse, sir, we are running out of time now.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And
yeah, just find
there are some questions, sir. If you want, you can continue with this slide, and there are some questions that people have asked.
Right, I'll just wind up within 5 minutes, okay?
Yes, sure, sir.
Then regarding hotels and hospitality, there has to be increase in the frequency of cleaning in the rooms in the common areas. The strategy is to implement contactless check-in and provide guests with a hygiene welcome kit, low contact and technology-based equipments and appliances, then keep physical distancing from use of all common spaces, create positions such as hygiene manager and guest guardians, entrance to have mandatory hand hygiene, that is sanitizer dispenser and thermal screening provisions, respiratory etiquettes to be strictly followed, details of the guest, travel history, medical condition, along with the ID and self-declaration form must be provided by the guest at the reception. The large gatherings, congregations continue to remain prohibited. Luggage should be disinfected. So a lot of hotels are now using the UV machines. Then for tour operators and travel agencies, they need to promote domestic tourism. Sorry. Ensure safety of employees' health, promote digital communication, develop segmented and sustainable products focused on nature, rural areas and culture, and create personalized and small group tours and packages. For attractions, respiratory etiquettes and social distancing to be strictly followed. Then reduce touch areas where possible and sanitize high touch surfaces frequently. Protect employees with various approaches, including barriers, protective coverage, and distancing. Implement new technologies such as augmented reality, virtual reality to improve visitors' experience before, during, and after a visit, and encourage online payments and pre-bookings. Right? Regarding employees, only asymptomatic staff and guests shall be allowed. All staff and guests to be allowed entry only if using face cover masks. The face cover mask has to be worn at all the times. Protect employees from various approaches, including barriers, protective coverings, and distancing. Reduce contact between tourists and employees by using technology, self-monitoring of health, installation and use of Arogya Setu app, regular and repeated disinfection of all common areas. Provide safety kits, sanitizers, gloves, PPE kits to the employees. Entrance to have mandatory hand sanitizer, of course. Older employees, pregnant employees, and employees who have underlying medical conditions should take extra precautions. Meetings, as far as possible, should be done through video conferencing only. And that is the reason companies like Zoom and Google Meet and Microsoft Teams, they have all multiplied their business shares now. Separate entry and exit for officers, staff, and visitors. Large gatherings should be continued to remain prohibited. And posters, standees, audiovisual media on preventive measures about COVID should be displayed prominently, right? So as of now, for restarting tourism, it's hashtag dream today and travel tomorrow. So you may plan travel today for maybe 2 months or 3 months down the line. Thank you so much. So I'll stop sharing now. And
so we have a few questions. Maybe more than a few questions are there. Right. We can answer as per your wish, sir. Like whichever question you want to answer.
There are 54. There are 54 questions.
No chats are there, but maybe like more than 30 questions will be there. I'm leaving it to be like okay. Around 20-30 questions.
Right. Let me just go through them. What is this yes sir for? Okay, all of you are required to fill up your attendance and feedback form for slot 2. And this will be a new slot. Now, very naive question has been asked, how much actual time will it take to recover travel industry, sir? Not even the God knows about this answer. So I'm not in a position to answer this question because as and when the pandemic scenario improves, we will see a recovery. And I'm a very optimistic person. The recovery has already started. To begin with, domestic tourism has already been allowed. I've just quoted the names of four states who have started publicizing their tourism products in the new normal scenario. Being a tourism organization, what can we do to overcome this pandemic? We can simply wait for the vaccination to come. Otherwise, we are almost at a standstill as of now. But yes, domestic tourism is picking up. Travel is allowed in a lot of places now. So being in tourism organization, you simply should innovate and make such type of unique products. Like I'm getting a lot of advertisements from various standalone properties in rural setting, right? They're asking us to come to Rajasthan, come to Madhya Pradesh. अभी बड़े चेंज की बात नहीं हो रही, छोटे छोटे स्टैंड अलोन प्रॉपर्टीज होम स्टेज भी आपको इनवाइट कर रहे हैं. सो यू हैव टू इनोवेट सर्टेन थिंग्स लाइक वर्चुअल टूर्स एंड ऑल. Okay, then we have why can't tourism contribute on organizing better infrastructure to rise to the domestic tours? Obviously, tourism is contributing. Wherever we develop anything from tourism perspective, right, the infrastructure automatically gets placed. So wherever you will have the flow of the tourists, you will find that the infrastructure is developed. So it's an indirect or a direct impact, and there is a contribution. Yahan pe bhi tourists pahunchenge, wahan ka development to automatically hona hi hona hai. There is no question of tourism not contributing to the development of a particular area. When we talk about innovation and sustainability in tourism, what the tourism professionals can contribute and how? Like I just given you an example of one of our students pass out. She started virtual tours. This is an innovation, right? And it is sustainability because there is no mass tourism. So we can have any number of ideas. Like what I feel one of our BBA pass out has started a caravan business of caravan tours. Now आने वाले समय पे क्या होगा, हम लोग ग्रुप के साथ जाना पसंद नहीं करेंगे. We would like to travel only with our known people. With whom we have less of anxiety about protocols and cleanliness and hygiene issues, so businesses like caravan tourism will definitely pick up. We would like to travel along with our family alone, right, in secluded environment. So such type of standalone properties, apartments, tourist villas, vacation houses, and caravan tourism is going to pick up. These are the innovations that one needs to do. Do you think MICE tourism will totally crash because of the pandemic? Not at all. Nothing is going to crash. We are bound to recover. We are bound to bounce back. Now, I know a lot of students who are working in the MICE sector. So they've started a new form of business of organizing business meetings. Right? So virtually. So this is innovation. You need some sort of innovation to overcome the pandemic scenario. But mark my words, nothing is going to crash. I've just told you a word that has been coined up is revenge tourism. So we are bound to bounce back as a revenge for tourism in all its aspects. Looking at the way people are carrying themselves these days, do you really think most Indians actually care about the pandemic seriously anymore? My personal opinion is that we have become very casual and careless in our approach. Though the numbers are increasing, but the fear of pandemic is decreasing. So, because 81% is the recovery rate, ab logo ko lagne laga it is just like another flu. Even if you get it, you are home quarantine and all. So, thoda sa dar to kam ho gaya hai. Number isiliye badh raha hai because we are not taking the concept of SMS seriously, social distancing, right, and sanitizers. तो अभी हम उस चीज को सीरियसली नहीं ले पा रहे हैं एक्चुअली. आई थिंक COVID-19 डैमेज इट विल टेक एटलीस्ट 2 to 3 years टू रिकवर, बट अगेन नोबडी इज श्योर. इफ बाय डिसंबर वी हैव वैक्सीनेशन, बाय मार्च नेक्स्ट ईयर एवरीबडी इज वैक्सीन इन द एंटायर वर्ल्ड, वी विल हैव दिस रिवेंज टूरिज्म कमिंग बैक. हम अगर साल में 3 बार ट्रैवल करते हैं तो हम 5 बार ट्रैवल करेंगे एंड वी विल बाउंस बैक. But I believe, especially the air travel industry, hospitality industry will take at least 2 years to actually recover back. So please tell us about travel photographer. There was no travel photographer. The person concerned was is a tour manager, a tour guide. So they have innovated a new system. कि आप book कर रहे हैं, हम आपको virtual tour दिखाते हैं. टूरिस्ट साथ में नहीं घूम रहा है, बट टूरिस्ट को आप पूरा वीडियोस दिखा रहे हैं. विद द करंट इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशन विल बजट टूरिज्म बी प्रेफर्ड मोर देन लेजर टूरिज्म बाय टूरिस्ट ट्रैवलर्स? नाउ दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज ऑलवेज देयर. गिवन अ चॉइस, एवरीबॉडी वुड लाइक टू स्पेंड लेस अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, बट देन लग्जरी ट्रैवल सेगमेंट इज ऑलवेज देयर. एंड आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट रिवेंज टूरिज्म कॉन्सेप्ट विल बी फॉलोड बाय द लग्जरी ट्रैवलर्स बिकॉज दे हैव मोर डिस्पोजेबल इनकम इन हैंड. तो जब हमारे पास बहुत पैसा है तो हम चिंता किए खूब सारा पैसा खर्च करने की कोशिश करेंगे. बबल टूरिज्म इज ऑफ कोर्स गुड. जितने ज्यादा कंट्री से हमारा बबल एयर एग्रीमेंट होगा उतना ही ज्यादा कंट्री के लिए अच्छा होगा टूरिज्म बूस्ट करने के लिए. टेक अ लुक एट द क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई एम डूइंग राइट. We are bouncing back. जो losses होने थे वो हो चुके हैं. The future is going to be bright. Lot of questions are about the future which nobody knows. The priorities of
there are many questions actually. There are many questions.
There are many questions.
Yes, sir. You have answered.
I would suggest I have given you my email ID. If you can note down the questions and shoot an email to me, I'd love to answer everyone. I'm repeating my email ID. You can note it down. pawan.gupta. That's pawan.gupta@iitmnoida.ac.in. Right?
So if you can repeat it, please.
Yeah, it's pawan.gupta.
Yes.
@iitmnoida. iitmnoida.ac.in.
Fine, sir. Students, right. We have mentioned it in chat box also. You can check it from there.
Yeah. So I'm sorry, I'm unable to answer all the questions. There are too many questions. So I would request all of you, don't be afraid to write me an email. Give me an email and I'll try to answer all the questions possible. Right? Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.
I hope you have enjoyed this.
Happy listening to you. Yes, sir. We have a good number of thank yous coming. Proves that the session was good. Let's hope that they'll get to listen to you again at some other platform other day. Let's hope, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for the session.
Thank you. All the best to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Students, you may please take a break now and we'll rejoin at 3 o'clock with the next